Hi, my name is Mary Kim Arnold. I'm going to be reading a short section from a longer poem that I've been working on called Fin de Siècle. This appeared in the issue number 7 of Oversound Journal. Fin de Siècle. Back in the 90s, if you could tie a cherry stem in your mouth, it meant you were good with your tongue, and everyone wanted a piece of that. Leaning languidly against the tall green lockers when he called me condescending, and I was like, do you even know what that word means? Later, he drives me to the party anyway and runs his fingers through my hair while Wish You Were Here keeps playing on the radio like it's the only song there is. Downstairs in the carpeted basement, it's pitch dark, and I can't tell where my body ends and someone else's begins. But upstairs, it's too bright and too loud. I turn the corner, and there's that boy, the one I have wanted for so long, but he doesn't even know. I try to bump into him like they do in the movies, but he just muscles past. He's headed to the kitchen where that girl, the one who drives the red Trans Am into the high school parking lot at night with her trunk full of vodka and wine coolers, is waving him over, and I feel like I want to die. I just want to die. Someone else is behind me now. It's the locker guy, and he's spinning me around and trying to kiss me on my mouth. I'm not really that into it, but it's late, and I'm tired, so I let him. I just let him. Then later, after Everclear and blue Kool-Aid, after my face on the cold white tile, after he holds my hair back while I puke, after that party and then another, we're together that whole summer, taking baths in my tub. At night, it's so hot, we spray the bed sheets with water before we get in. We spray each other with water as cold as we can get it. It's fun for a while. We drink a lot and throw parties. We get high and dance. On the weekends, we take up space at the diner and talk about all that shit that went down. We talk so loud, we want everyone to hear us. We want everyone to know how fucking cool we are. Then that fall, I bury my mother, and when people ask me how I am, I say, now I am walking in the shadow of death, and after a while, they stop asking.